Rod Woodson here in studio. Let's talk about the Sunday games, yes. Roderick. You're Mr. Old School for many reasons, and the first playoff game between the Cowboys and Packers in Lambeau Field since the Ice Bowl.
That's crazy, isn't
coming it? Sunday, and it is supposed to be frigid. It's in the single digits there right now, and it may be just as cold when Tom meets ball on
January.
Sunday. What do you think about this one? It's only the third instance in the history of the NFL playoffs between a team that was perfect on the road during the regular season visiting a team that was perfect at home during the regular season.
Well, something's going to give on
it
that.
It has
one.
To give. Yes, sir.
I would say this, is that if the Dallas Cowboys cannot run the football against the Green Bay Packers, they have no shot of beating Aaron Rodgers. He's playing lights-out football. We all know that. And then if you look at their defense, talking about the Green Bay Packers, they have improved since midseason. They went from 25th overall to 15th overall total defense. Eddie Lacy, 5 out of last 7 games, has rushed for more than 5 yards per carry. So that's a good sign if you're a Green Bay Packers. And then DeMarco Murray has really struggled down the stretch. He's only averaging like 78 yards last 4 games, where in the previous weeks he was averaging about 125 yards a game. And mm-hmm. I think if they can't run the football, I just don't know if Tony Romo can outscore Aaron Rodgers in Green Bay. And I don't know if that defense, talking about the Dallas Cowboys secondary, which I think they're 25th in passing defense, can take care of Aaron Rodgers and Jordy Nelson.
And Rolando McClain, who was in many times
playing
their
really
best
good.
Player all season, yep. he couldn't play due to an illness, they were right. saying, and that he may not be able to practice until Friday this week is the word out of
Well, and he's been
the
their
Metroplex.
Best player. He's been their most consistent player all year
Amazing.
Long on defense. And which is great for Rolando McClain because he's a really good guy. He was there in Oakland when I was there, the 1 year I was coaching with the Raiders. He's a great guy, but I just don't know how the Dallas Cowboys can stay with Aaron Rodgers in that offense.
So you think the Packers advance?
I do, because I just think you can't outscore Aaron Rodgers in that offense in Green Bay.
So judging by your comments in the second hour where we talked about the Saturday games, you say it's a rematch of night one of the regular season in the last game of the NFC schedule for the right to go to Arizona. It will be Green Bay at Seattle again. You believe that's the case?
I do believe that. And I think Green Bay Packers are a better football team this time around than they were.
Well, you have to figure they're going to throw at Richard Sherman at least once, as opposed to cutting the field in half like they seem to do on night one.
I don't get that one, because when you're as good as Aaron Rodgers is and you have a player like Jordy Nelson, and when Jordy was matchup one, Richard Sherman, you never throw over there. You
or
never
back
look over
shoulder
there.
Once, right? Throw the back shoulder
once. Jordy Nelson has proven that he can catch the football in almost any defensive back in the National Football League this year, last couple years.
Right.
And when you're that good as Aaron Rodgers, you have to challenge him. He might have an off day.
They didn't at all.
And I think you can't be a complete offense if you don't use the whole field.
Mm-hmm.
Challenge the guy. So I think they'll do that if they did play again. And they're running the ball better. But then again, the defense for the Seattle Seahawks are playing really good football.
Lights
right now.
Out. So that's what you are predicting will be the NFC Championship game. And then the last game of the weekend, the Colts going to the Denver Broncos, which is another week one rematch. That was the first Sunday night game of the year. And Denver had its way against the Colts. What do you think about this time around?
And I'm calling that game for Westwood One.
Ah.
And I went back and watched that week one matchup.
Yep.
And if the Colts didn't start out slow like they did, they could have won that football game. But I think if you look at the two teams, they're about similar. But the difference is for the Denver Broncos is that they're running the football right now. They weren't running the football at the beginning of the year. You got to remember, Von Miller wasn't healthy. He played probably 35 snaps that first game. So he's healthy. And they brought in DeMarcus Ware to leave T.J. Ward for a reason. And it's for the postseason. And I think with those guys being there, with the defense, the way they've played this past year, they're really quietly one of the better defenses in the National Football League. They can get after opposing quarterbacks. And if Andrew Luck can't run the football, if they can't not run the football, they're going to struggle there.
Well, I don't see them running the football. I just don't. And you saw the reason why how they were moving the ball down the field was mostly with Boom Heron catching. He had
right.
10 receptions.
Right.
And then they passed to Moncrief, as Matt Hasselbeck pointed out. Luck threw in a double coverage instead of to a wide open Colby Fleener on the opposite side of the field, as Hasselbeck pointed out on yesterday's show. But as you mentioned about the running game for Denver, week one, they were trying out Monty Ball. right? He, yeah. who, by the way, was one of the top first-round fantasy picks this year.
Yep.
And many people who chose Monty Ball, like sixth, seventh overall right. in their fantasy drafts, were ruining that day. And then Ronnie Hillman gave it a go. When we saw the Broncos midseason on Thursday Night Football against the Chargers, that was Ronnie Hillman getting it done.
Right.
Now it's C.J. Anderson, who is electric and also very powerful at the same time. And this running game, Rod, many people are saying that has been so stout and so used is because Peyton's not feeling physically well enough to wing it like he did in the first half of the season, that the lower body, the thigh that he hurt throwing a block in the win over San Diego, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Where do you stand on the issue of the run game perhaps being relied upon for a reason?
Well, I still think you throw to score, but you run to win. And I think Adam Gase, I think John Fox, I think even Peyton realized that if they want to win down the stretch, they need to run the football. And they were five and one down the stretch in the last six games. But when the one loss, they didn't rush for over 120 yards of the total offense. When they're five wins, they rush for over 120 yards. And so the one key is they have to be able to run the football against the Indianapolis Colts. I think they will. I'm not going to sit there and say Peyton Manning's done. I think Peyton Manning has thrown the ball well. Julius Thomas has been banged up and beat up. Emmanuel Sanders has had a hamstring issue. So the extra week for those guys is going to be tremendous. I think he needs Julius Thomas to be the guy he was at the beginning of the year because he needs to throw the ball in the middle of the field.
Well, maybe the bye week will help him with that ankle as well.
I think he will.
That the bye week might help Julius Thomas as much as we're hoping, you know, for the Broncos fans are hoping and we in the media are hoping to see a game where everybody's healthy. Because that's what you want to see.
Absolutely.
That the bye week may be helping Peyton as much as and Julius Thomas as much. So judging by your comments, mixing hours two and three together, you believe every home team is winning. Every bye week team is winning this weekend. But, not to put words in your mouth, if you had to choose the one team that's most vulnerable, it would be the Patriots because of the Ravens.
You got it,
Rich. You hear that, Brockman?
You got it.
Well, America said the Broncos yesterday when we had that as a poll question, but I'm just saying.
What are you saying? You're nervous. You're nervous. Just admit it. It's okay. And I'm going to poke you like this for the next 2 days as well in studio. You best get used to it. You best get used to it.
Just think if it is in the divisional or the conference championships, looking ahead, if it is Patriots, Broncos, and then on the other side, you have Tony Romo going back to Seattle, the place where he dropped the snap and then they lost the game. I mean, that's pretty good theater right there.
Or the Packers going back there, too.
Or the Packers going back, yeah.
You know, obviously.
But no love for Ravens Colts.
No love for Ravens Colts.
That's going to be a great game, though.
And certainly not much love of Carolina fill in the blank.
The Rich Eisen Show, weekdays at noon Eastern. On Audience.